Assalamu alaikum, my name is Zarina, and I'm a graduate. You may have answered this question in part already. On the question of Dawah, many people ask me, how is it just for a very good, righteous non-Muslim to go to hell? For example, Mother Teresa. What happens to their good deeds, and what is the best way to answer them? Thank you.
Sister has a question, what about the righteous non-Muslim like Mother Teresa? Will she go to heaven or hell? As I mentioned in my talk, the criteria to go to heaven, the criteria to go to Jannah are four, according to Surah Al-Asr. Wal-Asr, innal insan lafi khusr, illa ladhina amanu, wa amilu salihati, wa tawasaw bil haqq, wa tawasaw bil sabr. By the token of time, man is very in a state of loss, except those who have faith, those who have righteous deed, those who do dawah, and those who exhort people to patient perseverance. Minimum four criteria are required to go to Jannah. Similarly, when I was in school, I passed my ICSE, in 1992, there were minimum six compulsory subjects. English was there, mathematics, science, history, geography, Hindi, compulsory. I ask you the question, sister. In science, in five subjects out of six, I get 99 out of 100. In one subject, I get 10 out of 100 in science. Will I pass standard 10? Yes or no? No. But I got 99 in English. 99 in Hindi, 99% in history. If I fail in any one subject, I fail. Similarly, to go to Jannah, four criteria are required. Iman, righteous deed, exhorting people to truth dawah, and exhorting people to patient perseverance. Now you say Mother Teresa was righteous. Righteousness includes offering salah, giving zakat, many things. But even if I agree with you for sake of argument or with a non-Muslim, then Mother Teresa was righteous for sake of argument. Huh? In Islam, righteousness includes many things, which I feel Mother Teresa didn't have. But even if I agree with you for sake of argument, she gets 99 only in one. What about Iman? So if she does shirk, which is even mentioned in the Bible, if you read the Bible in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 5, verse 7 to 9, and the book of Exodus, chapter number 20, verse number 3 to 5, it says that thou shalt have no other image of me. Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image of anything that is in the heavens above, in the earth beneath, and the water beneath the earth. Thou shalt not bow down to them, nor serve them, for I, thy God, thy Lord, is the jealous God. So doing shirk is even haram in Christianity. And in the Quran, Allah says in Surah Maida, chapter number 5, verse number 72, let's see what is the verdict given by Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, says in the Quran, in Surah Maida, chapter 5, verse 72, Allah says that لَقَدْ كَفْرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهُ هُوَ الْمَسِيحُ بْنُ مَرْيَمَ. They are doing kufr. They are blaspheming those who say that Jesus, son of Mary, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَقَالَ الْمَسِيحُ. But said Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, Ya Bani Israel, O children of Israel, اُعْبُدُ اللَّهِ, worship Allah, رَبِّي وَرَبَّكُمْ, who's my Lord and your Lord, إِنَّهُ مَا يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ. Anyone who associates partners with Allah, فَقَدْ حَرَّمَ عَلَيْهِ الْجَنَّةِ, Allah will make Jannat haram for him. وَمَا وَهُ النَّارِ وَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ أَنْصَارِ, and fire shall be his dwelling place, and he shall have no helpers in the hereafter. So Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, إِنَّوْ مَا يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ, anyone who associates partners with Allah, فَقَدْ حَرَّمَ عَلَيْهِ الْجَنَّةِ, Allah will make Jannat haram for him. Paradise will be forbidden for him. وَمَا وَهُ النَّارِ وَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ أَنْصَارِ, and fire shall be his dwelling place, and he shall have no helpers in the hereafter. So according to Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, according to the Quran, according to the Bible, if any human being does shirk, whether it be Mother Teresa or anyone else, they shall not enter Jannah.